Hello friends, in this video we are going to learn RDBMS system. So let's see. It is a relational model in which data is stored in multiple tables and they are related to each other with the help of primary key and foreign key. And what are the example of it? SQL Server, Oracle and MySQL and many more. And where to use it? In school database, bank or hospital information management system. Relational database management system, what it does, it means in which data is stored in multiple tables. This is the student table and they are related to each other. Suppose that student table is related to each other with the help of some keys. We can say relationship in between these two tables. There is a department table, means student having a one student is belongs to department, like department having a name like computer or IT. So these tables are related to each other with the help of some keys, means that particular means how we can identify that particular student is belongs to which department. So here is the department ID. We can say 1 1 2 2. 1 means Rahul is belongs to computer department, Nilesh is belongs to computer department, Ketan is belongs to IT department, Nikhil is department to IT department. So that student and department tables are related to each other with the help of some keys. Means ID is the primary key that will go into the student table as a foreign key. Means they are connected to each other with the help of some key. So known as the relational database management system. I am giving the example of only two tables, student and department, but in practically there are lots of tables belonging to the particular one system. Like say there is a school information management system, then if we have to design the database for school information management system SIMS, then we have to identify what are the different entities are come into the picture, like department, student, faculty, then there is a we can say class, or there is a subject and there is a mark sheet. So all these things are coming into the picture, so we can call it as an entity. And why this relational model is so popular? Because it is very easy to understand. Means we can store the data like the row and column format. These are nothing but the row and these are nothing but the column. So everyone can easily identify, yeah, these are the columns and these are the row and this is nothing but the cell data. Everyone can easily understand what is this. And means data is arranged in a tabular format known as the relation. And we can do any operations like DML operations. DML means data manipulation language in SQL. And we can do insert. We can insert, suppose there is a one, Rahul is the name, Pune, and then I click on save, I upload the photo of him, then when I click on save, then data is going to be insert. Means insert means from application to the database, Rahul, Pune, photo and its department. Here department we have to choose who is belongs to which department. Let's say here is the drop down or combo box, and we can select based on his ID. Data is saved into the database. If I have to alter, then Pune will be is Nasik or something like that. So that information is update, and with the help of update query we can simply update that particular one is at his, Rahul is at his, but that Pune is going to be updated from Pune to the Nashik. And third thing, there is a, if that student is not, we have to delete the record of that particular student, then here we can directly delete that particular row from the database. Means from the table, yeah. And why there is a one more thing, why we are actually popular this model, relational database management system, because it helps to reduce the redundancy. Means there is a in network model or a hierarchical model, there is a redundancy, means there is a insert, update, delete operations are to be more complicated as compared to this. That's why. And second thing, there is a redundancy means normalization. Here there is a computer, we can say, and here is the computer. So I have to IT, and instead of that particular computer, I will make a one separate table for it, means computer one time only, ID one time only, just refer that particular ID to here, and we can save the database size as well. We can remove the complications as well. We can remove the redundancies as well. In this session, we seen RDBMS system, and in the next session, we will see types of relationship and different types of modeling in database. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like it, share it, and please subscribe my channel. Thanks. Bye bye.